aim is to study the dependence of potential difference with respect to current through a resistor. Okay, the materials required are connecting wire, ammeter, voltmeter, one way key, battery alternator, rheostat and a resistor. Here you can see them all joined in the circuit diagram. I will explain the circuit diagram by doing the experiment. Here you have the symbols written and they are explained on the side. Now this is the observation. You can see where we find the range of the ammeter and the voltmeter, then the least count of ammeter and voltmeter, and then find the zero error and do the zero corrections. And then as we keep on changing the resistance, we find the different values, as we keep on varying the resistance, we find the different values of ammeter and voltmeter, and then find the resistance R1, R2, R3 and take their average. Okay? Okay. Here we have the battery eliminator. You can see the positive of the battery eliminator is connected to the positive of the ammeter. The negative of the ammeter is connected to the positive of the voltmeter. The negative of the voltmeter as well as the positive, both are in parallel with a resistor. The resistor on the other hand is connected to the rheostat on one side, let us say the lower part. The top part of the rheostat on the other side is connected to the key. Key's other terminal is connected to the negative of the battery. So first we find out the least count of the ammeter. Here we have a milliammeter. So the least count is 0.25 milliampere, which we multiply by 10 raised to the power of minus 3 to get in amperes. The least count of the voltmeter is 0.05 volt. The range of this voltmeter is 0 to 3 volts and the range of the ammeter is 0 to 15 milliamperes. Now let us start the experiment by putting on the battery eliminator. As we put on the battery eliminator and keep on changing the position of the rheostat, you will find that the position of the ammeter and voltmeter readings keep on changing. Now as we keep on changing the position of the rheostat, we note down the readings of ammeter and voltmeter in our observation table and then plot a graph between V and I. Okay, you can take more than 5 values also, but minimum 5 values are required to draw a straight line graph, which we will achieve. And after getting the different values of V and I, we note it down in the observation table and find the value of R.